Taylor is a woman who I think really all women can relate to. You know, after the pregnancy,
how long have you been there?
The drug addiction, the syphilis.
Dude, she's been knocking, dude.
What?
She's been knocking on the door.
I know, dude. I didn't.
Her house being burned down several times.
Dude, don't turn on the light. Don't do it, dude.
Taylor Goddard? No?
Gosh, dang it, I hate you! Rude! Dude, I'm freaking blinded!
Dude, you've been playing the Simpsons game all night?
No? Yes?
I'm sorry, I don't know who that is.
Can't believe you, dude.
Dude, just get out of here, I hate you. You turn on the light, I'm freaking blinded now.
But I'm sure he's a nice kid.
I'm not talking to you. It's over between us. I didn't mean that.
That describe me. Innovation.
You know what they should do? Is they should make like Listerine food strips. Like something other than mint flavor?
Perseverance.
A whole pizza? Oh, dude, a strip? Well, you could have little pepperoni dots on it, kind of like nerds.
A really good dresser. The last one. Of course, being hyphenated.
Well, maybe we should make them with like the consistency of margarine.
But just as important.
He's just really positive about everything. He's such an optimistic person, to the point of extremity, actually. Like one time his father wasn't impaled in a bizarre freak juggling incident. Just blood. Profusely just coming out of his left denticle. You know, his father ended up dying, and we couldn't gather the remains. But Taylor, yeah, he always looked, he just said it was for the best.
Oh! Hello? Oh. You gonna shoot something?
Fool, the door's open, dude. What are you doing?
Dude, I saw the window and I wanted to know if I could get through it. Sorry, if you guys need to cut that out, like.
I would say my life is pretty complex right now. I've compared it to, like, a small baby sea lion, a giant postal service worker, a small pygmy sheep, Fred Astaire, and sometimes Shakira. Here I stand all alone
tonight. Yet I wish I was gone and off your brain. Dating? I don't date a lot.
Yeah, we dated one time. Taylor's a pretty cool kid. It didn't really last long though.
Dude, right across the parking lot from us is like the hottest girl ever.
He wouldn't put out.
Kind of had a history going on.
Taylor Goddard. Probably on a scale of 1 to 10, 1,000.2%.
I just want to show you who, like, the kind of caliber of girls that I'm dating right now. So let's just go take a look real quick. Just grab that light if you can.
If I were to describe Taylor in a few words or maybe like an animal, It'd probably be a tiger. Like, you know, those striped tigers, or maybe a cheetah or something, because they're just kind of fast and crazy and just never mind. I don't remember that word. If you, like, shave their fur, there's not really anything on them. So I guess you could kind of say Taylor's a little fake, too. All right,
just peek through there. Don't let her see you, man. Okay, you got her?
Aw, dude, you weren't joking.
So if you want to really know the reason why me and Taylor broke up or whatever.
Dude, isn't she hot? She's beautiful.
It's because he's not a very good kisser.
Me and her, we were supposed to go on all these dates this past weekend. Dude, I totally blew her off.
Well, it's like weird because he's just coming at your face and it's like aimlessly.
She told me she wanted a relationship and I was hesitant, of course, at first.
I don't know. His eyes are like halfway open, halfway closed. It's just kind of crazy.
Just not the kind of girl that I was looking for right now. I don't want to be tied down to just one person, you know?
Like a, you had to like fishbowl the lips.
Don't go over there and talk to her about it. She's pretty bitter about us. Just keep it on the DL if you can, man. Appreciate it.
Who? But you know what I mean, right?
I've never been a person of the world. I've never had a lot of material things. Get my money right. I had a dream I could buy my way to heaven. When I awoke, I spent that on a necklace. I told God I'd be back in a second. Man, it's so hard not to act. But one day,
I hope to be able to contribute to this world with the financial freedom that I do have. The great poet Snoop D-O-double-G once said, I've got my mind on my money and my money on my mind. Rolling down the street, smoking Indo and sipping on gin and juice. And while half of that is true, the other half is only occasionally true.
I guess the money should have changed them. I guess I should have forget where I came from.
I have a few idols. People I really look up to. One of those, I think, has to be the great Zac Efron. I'm not really sure what he does, to be honest with you. But I was standing in the grocery store the other day, and I looked on the magazine rack, and I saw his face. That boy. That boy is going places. I'm pretty sure he was the kid in Home Alone.
Thank you.